this was a major decision that the clubs were being asked to take. And that decision was going to impact on the league going forward. You know, and it was important, I felt personally very important, that the material information was made available to those clubs. And I think when you, if you looked at the report, you'll see that there are several very material parts, pieces of information which weren't actually disclosed to the clubs. Like, for example, there's potentially up to £10 million of liabilities that could be payable, that could impact on their budgets for next season. They also weren't told that they would be able to get the cash that's there just now by other routes other than voting for the resolution. And also the potential issues that may be surrounding the restructuring proposals and discussions which are ongoing just now. So I thought all of these were really important pieces of information that should have been given to the clubs as the owners of the company, but weren't. I think firstly you have to look at that statement and say, to me, that's just a deflection. It's a deflection away to something that's not in the report, something which we didn't actually say. If you actually go back and look at our statements, Rangers never actually said that. And it's deflected away from what's not in the report. What we should be doing is going back to looking at what's in the report, looking at the material information which wasn't provided to the clubs, looking at the poor corporate governance in the organisation. We're going through a really important phase for Scottish football. You know, the society as a whole has got a number of challenges that we need to face with the COVID-19 situation. And we need to have faith and confidence in the people leading our game that they're going to come up with new ideas and creative ideas to take us forward. And events like this do nothing, absolutely nothing, to give us that confidence. I think there's lots there that people should take very seriously. I think if you look at the fact that the executive didn't provide the clubs with the material information that they should have been provided with to allow them to make a fully informed decision, then that to me is pretty fundamental. You know, this league is a company which is owned by the clubs. You know, the executive work for the clubs. It shouldn't be up to them to pick and choose what material information they give them or don't give them. They should be giving them it all and then let them make a fully informed decision. That wasn't done in this situation. I spoke to a few clubs, and the ones I've spoken to have certainly been disappointed in what they've seen, because they're really disappointed in the manner of the information which they haven't been provided with. And they feel that they should have been provided with that information prior to the vote.